And we in this motherfucking thing on a Thursday motherfucking night.
Yeah,
it's your boy Pop.
And it's your girl Bray over here on Pop Radio Worldwide, Spotify Premium.
And all that good shit. I own all that. You feel me?
Yes.
We got Big Anthony in the building.
It's my
testosterone co-host around this motherfucker.
You already know, y'all. It's your boy Big Ant with Pop Radio Worldwide.
It's the gorilla.
And iHeartRadio, Spotify.com. Y'all know it's coming to y'all live, baby.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
We doing a lot, man. I got a lot of news.
I
wasn't going to do a show today because just getting back in town, I'm involved in a lot of projects. I'm just really trying to stick to Sexy Saturdays. But I had my girl come from a long way, so I had to open up the House of Pain and put on people, because that's what Putting On People Radio do. I got an event tomorrow that's going down that all my players are hustlers and money-getting girls.
Uh-huh.
Gonna want to come and support, and tomorrow night at Oceans, my girl Debbie, you know I rock with Debbie 150,000%. It is called the Strippers Olympics. Booty shaking, ass clapping. Look, it's love from Pop for all the long legs, beautiful ladies, all the, you know, all that good stuff. You know
all
what I'm saying?
Sexy women.
No, on some real stuff though, it's been a hell of a pandemic. So if anybody is supporting this craft from an artist standpoint, or anybody who comes from the industry standpoint, you gotta salute them. So Debbie been consistent since Father's Day. She opened up just her little patio out there. She went even further and beyond. I said, Debbie, I think you should go and get you a dunk tank. Debbie went and bought her a dunk tank. You know what I'm saying? And ran the patio with the food and whatnot. And thanks to Debbie, man, we've been able to, you know, continue a positive place to go to and throw some dope motherfucking events, eat some motherfucking good-ass burgers,
good
eat some good-ass fries, and get you a dope-ass little lap dance. You know what I'm saying? So let's make some noise for Debbie. I'm gonna let my boy Anthony properly introduce everybody who's in the motherfucking building, from Dolly and the whole panel, man. So I ain't gonna do that. You introduce yourself and everybody else, brother, the people of Pop Radio Worldwide.
It's Big Air here, y'all. We got a couple great people in the building. We got Dolly,
hey.
Right to the right of me, y'all.
Make some noise for Dolly. You know, we be on that extra testosterone shit around this motherfucker.
I love it. I love it.
Oh, yeah. We got Meeks to the left of me.
Meeks, all right. Make some noise for Meeks.
Yeah, the mic way, way far away from me. But my name is Melissa Meeks. Lovely to be here with y'all. Like, what are we doing, Josh? What is the move this weekend?
Yeah, make some noise for Josh, y'all. Josh is not a rapper, is not nothing, but he's something you should know in the industry, man. Has a lot of plugs. Be all out West Coast with it. And it's something, man, if you were Latino, man, trying to get your career also to the next level, and you out west, you trying to do a dope video in a mansion, get some dope little Rarys or whatnot, and just maybe need some security or whatever, you know, he'll probably direct you in the right way, man, some cookies, some, you know, whatever it is you need. Josh is here to bless us, man, for the weekend. He gonna turn up with us tonight at Oceans. He gonna turn up with us tomorrow night at Oceans. And now we gonna get it cracked. We got topics and all type of motherfuckers. And what kind of shit we talking about tonight on Pop Radio?
Today we pretty much talking about a range of things. We're gonna start off with something simple. It's what's expected of a man in a relationship nowadays. You know, it changes.
And it varies.
People say
I love the way you be cracking in the head sometimes out of left
field. You know, different groups.
And I think it's balanced out in here. We can talk about
it. I think so. That's the point of it, you know, because it's easy to have
Thursdays,
like,
baby. You get thick up in this motherfucker.
It's easy to have, like, one perspective, you know what I'm saying? But we want to hear, like, both sides of it. You know?
Dolly. I'm going to start with Dolly.
Let's start with Dolly.
Number one, thank you to my comrade for bringing such a good discussion that I think we can all bounce around real quick. Dolly, introduce yourself to people at Pop Radio, iHeartRadio, Spotify, Premium, how you coming, where you from, where they can follow you at, and so they can real quick just go look at you right now.
So, my name is Dolly Games, and shout out to Pops for having us over here on Pop Radio. You can find me on Instagram at DollyGames_. It's not hard to find. Dolly Games, straight to the point. I love the topic we're talking about tonight.
So I'm going to ask you this myself. Beautiful. It's a tough game. It's a tough industry.
Yes.
And it's from where Pop, you know, I did 20 years. You know, so I come, you know, from Buck Rogers to a whole nother time. You know what I'm saying? Also, real quick, salute to Big Easy. I see you all tuned in. Big Easy, salute to you, gang, nigga. So, question, topic, what should be expected from a female of a man in a relationship?
So, we had an interesting discussion about this earlier, but what should be expected from a man of a woman, to me, is independency, she's intelligence, you know, optimism, and just the drive and ambition from a woman. A man is looking for somebody that he can spoil, but also contribute, you know, not just like he's got to save her and fix her up and everything, but these women got it hella messed up out here now these days, you know? So to expect things from a man, I could go both ways because I have a book that's coming out about it, and it breaks it down. What a man's expecting of a woman.
Well, they call that shit a shameful plug. Do your shit. You hear me? Do your shit. So
everything a woman brings to a table, a man should bring that back.
Exactly.
I'm
going to get to you in 1 second, July. You hear me?
So my thing
you
is,
hold that thought.
What a man's looking for, he's looking for the beauty, he's looking for the intelligence, he's looking for inspiration. But the biggest thing a man needs from a woman is not just independency, but peace.
I'm with the peace. Okay. I'm going to shake this shit around a little bit. Thank you very, very much for your answer. I respect it. I want some testosterone in the building. Josh, my question to you, sir, is everybody make some noise for Josh in the building. One of my dogs. So check this out, Papa. Quick to the point, right? I got 10 minute segments. So straight to the point, right? What do you think is a woman's expectations of a man, real quick?
What's the expectations of a man?
You know, what do they expect of a man, my nigga? You know what I'm saying?
To be there for them, to love them, to care for them, to appreciate them, and to hear them out. You know what I mean?
Okay.
That's the main thing, is just to hear them out.
Okay.
Because a lot of times, even when they're wrong or something, if you take the time to hear them out and understand why they are wrong, they appreciate it a lot better.
That's why you got so many hoes. That's what it got.
That's right.
You
know
what I mean? That's why, yo. That's why that nigga right there. So hey, Bree.
Yes.
What do you expect of a motherfucking man?
Well, working in the industry, and since I've been co-hosting on your show, it's really hard for somebody to, like, well, my man is actually really good at it, and I expect this and nothing less, to be able to understand that there are times where I have to go and, you know, work at times that are maybe not planned, and that's what I want to do, and he has to respect that, you know?
Yes.
To be on call, he has to respect that I'm on call, and also to help me if I need to chase my dreams. Like, what I'm doing right now is such a great opportunity.
So he should be supportive?
Supportive to everything that I want to do, and...
What else? What's expected of a man? Be supportive, loving. What else?
What's to be expected is to be able to, you know how you said we have to be a man's piece? They also have to be my piece, because working in this industry, it's so stressful that I don't have to have extra baggage from a man. You know, I could be my own piece. So if I have somebody else, you know, stressing me and bringing me down, I don't need that.
Big ass and Prince of Pain will be back with our thoughts. And our opinion on what we think is expected of a man. When we come back at this little music break, make some noise again for my man.
These ain't no guest jeans. I dropped out of school, I'm still getting mad, but nigga don't test me. I play to the left, they went to the right, they try to finesse me. Still running around with that blicky, I hope they don't catch me.
Don't get this nowhere but Pop Radio Worldwide, iHeartRadio, Spotify Premium. So, real quickly, y'all, I do want to send a shout out to not only our local artists that rock with Pop and are always in my DM and on my social media sharing my shit, saying something positive in my inbox, seeing me in traffic with my mom or at the store getting squares, or and just giving me something inspirational, man, letting me know that I'm here for a reason, that I inspire a lot of Latinos.
You do.
And that you know, I just want to let y'all know, bro, sometimes even though I give you a hard, strong demeanor and personality, bro, I just be at the bag, bro, and I just don't be extra friendly or whatnot, because I did a lot of time and I went through some shit. But I love everybody's great energy. I take all the compliments, I take all the great encouraged words, and I love y'all back. I don't give a fuck what mob you the fuck in, my brother, you know what I'm saying? I was locked up with the best of them. You know what I'm saying? And we all had one fight, and that was human rights, man. And we all fought with them against dumb peoples. Got maced up, got shot at. I'm one of the ones that did get shot at prison, so I'm not just talking. But, you know, we all fought together, hunger strikes. Man, I had, you might call them ops, you know, but I had ops bring my mama to the joint, or they people ride with my people to come visit me. And, you know, we looked out for one another. You know what I'm saying? So you get to a level in education and life where you really understand what an op is, bro. And it ain't a brother in the same struggle, man. I'll tell y'all that. You know what I'm saying? I'm glad I wrote right up on guys that 20 years ago, y'all was my ops. And now I look at y'all like my younger brothers. You know what I'm saying? Salute to all them counts that caught me the other day out south and was like, Pop, we love you, took pictures with me. And that's real, you know, real stuff. I was taking my mom to the casino. And Nico and them from the counts rolled up on me. Hey, Pop, can we get a picture, bro?
That's love.
You know what I'm saying? I'm glad that my music and movement influences y'all, and it really lets y'all know it ain't never too late to reinvent yourself, stunt, shine, none of that. You know what I'm saying? To be a better person.
Right.
So I'm going to get back to this motherfucking answer. No. You know what? I'm the last nigga in the house that gets to answer.
You going to throw it on me.
So what do you think is expected, bro? So for those just tuning back in, we were just talking about, we asked everybody else, the topic of the night is on Thick Thursdays. It is, what do we think is expected of a man in a relationship? So let's get with it, man.
What would you do if you was in a relationship? That's a real question.
See, I think, like, Pop, though, you got to
I'm going to let him answer that, and I'll answer your question.
Because there's different types of men in different situations.
That's why you're getting a whole bunch of different testosterone here tonight. What you think is expected of
him? To say a more balanced answer, you know, I think usually what's expected is you know, a contribution, you know. And I think that's something that's kind of like being less missing from the family structure. Like, unless a lot of women nowadays, women expect men to contribute pretty much everything. And that's the thing that kind of like is an argument sometimes.
That's not a real woman.
But I agree. 100%. And it depends on...
Do me a favor, right?
What?
Let's get a little bit more conscious, right? Yeah. Give me, like, more so these females that are listening...
Right.
Not what you think is expected, but what you think in your brain that they expect of us. So give me four of those real quick.
You know what? That's what I was trying to get to.
Yeah.
But I would say what they expect is kind of like to be there for me, so to speak. And that's understandable.
Man, you want to go a little bit further?
No, I'm saying like honestly, more catering.
I'm going to go there.
I'm going there. I get what you're what you trying to say? I'm trying to dance a little bit.
Turn that off.
Let's go.
I'm going to light this motherfucker up.
Oh, man. I'm fat, bro. I'm trying to dance on.
No, you know what? Number one, let me ring the bell. This is the House of Pain. It's putting on people radio, so it's for the people. But it's pop show, and I appreciate Bree that come out every motherfucking show rocking me. I appreciate Anthony that had a rough fucking day with me today.
Like, oh man,
I'm surprised he's even here. So, and thank you for the ideas of the topics and the moral support and all that you give me every day, bro. You know what I'm saying?
Much
I
love,
fuck
bro.
With you. I love you for that. But we're gonna keep this rope, right?
All right.
I'm not gonna let it, you know, the shit sync on us, and we're gonna keep the same energy.
Right. Yeah,
so great. I'm gonna give you both. I think both. Well, Mills, you had a question for me.
Meeks, you mean Meeks?
Meek Mills, right?
No.
What's your name? No,
Meeks.
It's Mills.
Just Meeks.
Okay.
No Mills.
All right. Come on, Meeks, give it to me.
Melissa Meeks.
You got a question for us? Listen.
Well, you had a question for me. I might be able to answer it.
Okay. No, we're on this male expectation stuff. You had stopped and said. You said you had a question for me, right?
I think that every female has their own personal expectations of a man.
Absolutely.
Because every single individual is a different person.
Right.
So what I may expect from a man may be
another
different from what she expects from a man or what she expects from a man. So I feel like anytime you ask a question, there's no like right answer or there's no wrong answer. It's
I don't want the right answer.
Yeah, it's like,
I want
like,
what you think, baby. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna chime in.
I'm gonna keep it real.
I'm gonna chime in.
Hold on one second. So I have different expectations for every man in my life.
Okay.
Right.
Because every man is different.
Okay.
Definitely.
Now, can I?
You can't expect the same thing from every man.
Monday,
Can I open my mouth?
I got a man for every fucking day of the week.
Check this out. Check this out.
See you on Sunday.
Okay. I got different expectations.
So check this out, though, Dolly. Dolly. Check me out, though, right? Sit in my chair for a minute. Sit in big ass chair for a second, lady. Respectfully, I respect everything you said, and you're, Melissa, you're 100%. And it's every man, you know, got to step to you different, number one.
There you go.
I understand that you want one on Sundays, you might want one on Mondays, and they both got to be, one got to flip pancakes, one got to, you know how to pour up your favorite drink.
I get that.
Okay, I get that. A lot of people might think I like them seven different kind of flavors in different ways, but the truth of the matter is, I'm going to tell y'all, so personally, right, I date once in a while. You know, I've been single for 3 years, and I think, so the expectations is not a problem for me, but I do realize by working with so many females that
there causes issues in your
because I don't want to interrupt my opinion. There is a lot of females, so there's different kind of females. There's females that don't even deserve my attention and time to date them and even worry about their expectations because they don't have enough to offer me.
Okay?
Then there's females that I need to learn how to step to. I need to find out and realize what their expectations are, and if maybe with my lifestyle that is a little bit much and complicated, if it ain't gonna make it too booty hurt, and if it can match with that.
Right.
But of course, it's supporting your woman, pushing her dreams, listening to her, fucking her right, so another motherfucker don't fuck her right. You know, on top of that, if she's, I would say, also instill empowerment in your female.
Yes.
Teach her some games. Show how to make some bread. Build more than just a relationship. Build an empire.
Yes.
If that's going to be your boo.
Right.
You know, and if she can't pass that application of expectations, then you do not need to be doing nothing other than just having her on Sunday or Monday.
Okay.
It's your boy, Prince of Pain.
Yeah.
We're going to take another little music break. You know what I'm saying? It's a lot of shit going on around this. Okay. Make some noise for all these sexy motherfuckers. Look, man, I've been fortunate, man, to not only play this OG role and card, I guess, that I do in the industry.
Okay, wait.
And it's been fun, man. It's been a great ride. It's been trifling sometimes. And it's Chicago, and I come from a rough city, so we've had to turn up sometimes and earn our respect instead of just walking through and just, you know, getting it, you know. We've also have traveled cross-country. I'm very, very inspired and blessed to have worked with some of the people who started my career, man, and showing me some of the big ropes, big contracts, and how to really move, man, to tell you the truth, you know what I'm saying? Hypno Carlito, man, wherever you at right now, man, I love you, bro. Cold Heart, wherever you at, I love you, bro, from Crucial Conflict. Cuban Link, with your last, I love you too, my nigga, you know what I'm saying? And every promoter, man, that gave Pop a shot, bro, and just gave me 30 minutes of time, and let me take your theater or your strip joint, baby, for a night, and or every security guy that just took the ride to New York or LA and just didn't give a fuck and just had my back. I love y'all. I love y'all. Look, let's make some noise. Look, we made a little bit of ruckus around here talking about all this, what female they back on my baby and all that.
Nah.
I'm gonna switch it up real quick. Look, my fellas, yes, I got the OnlyFans started, but I gotta learn if I can share the extra shit. I don't think so. But I did get the Patreon page started, popular worldwide, where I can share the extra stuff, and I'm gonna give all that beautiful extra stuff that don't nobody in Chicago but Bob get soon when it's ready in time, maybe a week. But right now, it's Thick Thursdays, baby. It's another part of Sexy Saturdays and Turn Up Tuesdays. Right now, it's that time when we ask the ladies, man, in the building. We just got the testosterone out the house. Now we gonna ask the beautiful ladies in the building a freaky fun fact about themselves on Thick Thursdays. You know what I'm saying?
Is that the mic department?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Well, you can start with Dottie and then I'll ask them.
No,
big
I
want to
go last on this one.
Okay. Melissa, you ready for this, baby? I'll start.
I'm going to give you a question.
I'll start. No.
Just, no, we ask some questions
and you answer them.
Yeah, okay.
I'll start first. Let me go first.
Okay. This is an operation here, bitch.
Melissa, look at me, baby. Beautiful. This is very mild. We just try to give the listeners a little bit something different, you know, a little sauce. I'm going to ask you first. My question to you is, do you like when a man talk to you and he don't talk to you in me?
Please don't speak to me.
Don't growl, none of that. Be quiet.
What we're doing.
Okay.
You don't want him to tell you like, damn, bro, this pussy feels tight.
That's my
ass. All lies. They don't tell that to any bitch. Like, whatever makes sense, we're going to say.
But it don't
like, don't believe anything a man has to say to you because it's all cat.
Oh, boy.
Big cat with everything they say.
I differ to that. If I tell you that shit, too. If that shit feel good, it feel good, guys. Okay, okay, Anthony, ask Melissa another question.
I'm still stuck on that one. Like, oh, what?
Well, I'm gonna let you ask another question and let us make us say all again.
What's a good question?
You're last.
Okay, yeah, I'm last.
No, she's last.
Oh, me?
You go on with your question.
Favorite type of first date? Go. Like it.
Favorite type of first date? Okay, we'll do that. That'll be acceptable for a Thick Thursday. Where you want that? Where you want that boy to take you that first date?
Let's just chill, catch a vibe, get a bottle, drink something like
Netflix and fuck.
What the fuck? Really? That's what it sounds like.
Come on, bro.
Let
that boy take you up for baby back ribs or some shit.
Catch a vibe. Like you gotta understand their vibe. You gotta understand like how you vibe.
Can I be honest with you? If I'm coming to pick somebody up and she know what kind of night we gonna have. The vibe is there before I get there, baby. Tell you,
hey.
You know what I'm saying? So, Bree, go hit Melissa with your question. Cool. Melissa, you got one more question, baby.
So I got a question. Let's hear it, baby. Would you be down to like, if you're really feeling somebody, y'all are vibing? Would you be acceptable with car sex, air mattress sex? Or are you gonna be like, nah?
You ain't never did it in the car.
You ain't never did it in an air mattress.
Girl, who you asking that question to?
It's Thursday.
Have you ever?
I did it in the car. Okay, Don. We going to Don.
I'm definitely going to Don.
We
gonna
have
some
more that
okay. Order in the house of prayer. Order in the house of prayer. Okay, Don. I'm gonna make this real simple. Right? What's the most silliest, most exotic place, maybe like a car, that you've ever had sex with?
Okay, so hear me what I said. So, yes, the most silliest, the most exotic place I've ever had sex in is in a pilot cockpit while playing.
Wild oh shit.
Hey, that's
the high flight pussy. Yeah, really? Top flight pussy. Top flight pussy, my man. I like that. That's dope. Big A, that's your question for Doc.
Oh, man.
And be careful. That's top flight pussy right here.
I can't ask a regular question of this.
No.
There's levels to this pussy.
Yes.
Super exclusive.
So, if your man was to surprise you with a gift, what type of gift? If you had a man and you wanted him to surprise you with a gift without having to tell him what it is, necessarily, I know it sounds silly a little bit, but what type of gift would you expect to, like, want? What do you think a man should give a woman as a surprise gift?
So,
you
know? For a woman who could buy anything she wants and go anywhere she wants, he has to really know me, what I love, what makes me happy, right? So what makes me happy is my daughter, family time, cooking, and traveling. So if a man really fucks with me, he knows what to get me.
On Sunday or Monday?
Get me a sexy-ass dress.
On Sunday or Monday?
Baby, this is the man.
The 7 day week.
This is my 7 day
okay.
week. This so is
hold
on.
I'm going to stay with you now,
yes,
Dolly.
Yes. This is a man that knows me.
If you give me a persona, I'm okay. So, now, if you want to come correct now.
Yes, so if you want to come correct.
Don't be that 7 day
of the man
week.
Who really knows me, the perfect gift is having a dress laid out, having a car pick me up to go get my hair done, my nails done, and saying, meet me here.
How do we get to the
time?
Freaky stuff?
I get on the plane and go.
You're supposed to be on the freaky fun fact. It's something like the expectation.
I haven't been to on the map. And taking me somewhere.
I gotta buy a
dress. I'm into history.
But I love it. You know,
I'm into history.
Shit. I was like wondering where the freaky fun fact went to, but I'm picturing myself buying it.
I'm about to get you some freaky fun facts. I got you.
Let her finish.
But my thing is, for me personally, like a man who really fucks with me knows again, is setting it up and then getting me on the plane and taking me to that place that I've never been to on the map. And I'm a history person. I love studying history and culture. So when I get to that place, he's going to take me to different places. He's going to tell me what's the greatest food. He's going to take me to the places that I can learn.
That ain't no free. That's a fantasy.
And then I'm going to fuck him. And then, no.
I swear, she took me to like, do my look at touch my toes.
Hey, I got a fun story for you. You can ask me about it. That just happened in Atlanta. But no, seriously, a man who fucks with me from Sunday through Saturday, that's what he does
gotta
for me.
Like
because I'm too busy and I can't.
You got to take her to Egypt. You got to put
fan
her on the sand
and
all that.
You
want to
swim with the hippopotamuses in Madagascar?
Y'all got to understand. The bell rings around this shit. I got 10 minutes. I'm on paid time. You get it? Look, shout out to Street Level Youth Media, Chicago Lead Alliance, Oceans Nightclub, District in Chicago, and Diamonds Bar. I fuck with y'all. Fuck with them. Big Easy, thank you for checking in. I am going to play a joint. Everybody make some noise for Bags that's in the motherfucking game. I didn't even charge him. You hear me? Laugh for that one, motherfucker. So anyways, Bree is going to ask you a question, and then I'm going to ask her a question. Hold on 1 second. Oh, Bree's got a question for you real quick. Sorry for that, my audience.
Lights on or lights off?
They do when you're going to have to ask smack or not smack.
Lights on or lights off?
And you like to be physically, like, you know, pushed. In
oh, yeah.
Grab, like, so,
do you hear followers? So Donnie said, yes, when you're that 7 day or the
both.
1 day or the 7 day dude, look,
I'm
she like the passionate, lights on. She wants to see, you know, it happen. I like that. What sign are you?
Depends who it is. I'm a Virgo. So I'm the goddess of the universe. I'm the earth sign. I adapt to anything.
Virgo, yes. Virgo.
And it's Virgo season.
Okay. Before we go to our music break, I am going to ask my co-host, Bree, and I'm going to ask this. My brother would have some shit in a second. But I do want to ask Bree a question. Bree, what is your freaky fun fact, man?
My freaky fun fact is I like an eight from the back and not the front.
Eight from the back and not the front. Okay. I'm up out this motherfucker. It's your girl Mulatto. You feel me?
Hey, he gon' catch it. I ain't athletic, but this team is for the niggas. Hey, what that cash at? Stacking like Tetris. Real gutter bitch, real plugs and connections. First, I make a meet until he locked jaw. Give it to him good, knock the niggas socks off. I run it up.
When I feel like I'm supposed to be, don't let this nigga get close to me. Ain't shit changed, she give me brains, she give me neck like a rosary. Trippin' in the way I'm supposed to be, these niggas ain't never approaching me. I'm on my bad, they give me mad, half of these bitches be blowing me. Half of these bitches be going, only in it for the money. I'll be out chasing them honey, pocket full of blue honey. Said I'ma blow away the pain. Say all this heavy, keep on pulling in my cup like it's a rainy day. Say all my niggas in the game.
Bang on Pop Radio, John Wayne, Big Easy, Bags in the building. God. Bags.
Yeah.
Let me get that, man. What's the name of that joint?
Man, Blow Away the Pain.
Blow Away the Pain. I thought it was John Wayne.
John Wayne.
Okay.
Blow Away the Pain.
Okay, Blow Away the Pain, John Wayne.
Bang, bang.
Big Easy, Bags. Bags, say what's up to the people of Pop Radio.
Follow me on Instagram, man, BAGG1985, man. Check me out, bro. I got some real stories behind my shit, real talk. I'm lacking on my shit.
Where you from, Bags? What you repping?
Chicago, man.
Chicago. What side of town you repping, bro?
Logan Square,
Humboldt Park. Check them out, man. I personally know Bags now under the radar about a good year. I'm going to tell the story now. I got up on Bags, man. I didn't even know he was a rapper. I know he got shot.
Oh,
and he was Big Easy's friend, which is my friend that's a rapper. That was also on this track,
yeah,
and I seen one of the guys got shot, and I start, you know, showing my man a little support while he was shot up, and it was inspirational to watch him coming out of a studio, even though I wasn't even aware of his music, just to come out of a studio, trying to lay down some music, you know, package the pain, package the music, and do something productive and positive, like I beat you, and I ain't trying to slang no bricks no more. I'm not trying to stick no motherfuckers up no more. I did the 20 years. I learned. So when I see my man doing his positive little run and get lit up, I was like, wow, that's right. You know what I'm saying? So
yeah.
I started supporting my man just on the love side. You know what I'm saying? So he started doing a lot of videos and music, started tagging me with 99 other motherfuckers and whatnot. And you know, he's working right now, man. And I humbly want everybody to make some noise for him, man. Let him know that he's loved him. And he's here for a reason. You know what I'm saying? Everything don't happen overnight, man, but everything happens. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, storytelling.
Yes. Yeah. So everybody fuck with Bags 1985.
Yeah, BAGG 1985.
Fuck with the track, you know. And any shout-outs tonight, Bags, real quick.
Man, shout out to Pop, shout out to everybody here, you know, that's been here for me since day one. Big Easy, Sandbox.
Big Easy, strong, though. Woozy, Maserati, all quick.
Strong and everybody in the crew,
yes.
Man.
We love y'all.
Boy, everybody.
This one's down, Dwight.
Dwight. Everybody in this bitch.
Call Dwight, Cannon.
Cannon, hey, Cannon shot. Call Dwight. So much of my videos, Cannon better get back in tune. That's what I got to say.
So listen, I see already I've been in here over a time. And overnight, I think this one's up. So I think I've been here over time, past my time. Dolly came in here late. My time is very expensive, but I do want
to
make you aware. Is it on that one? Okay. I do want
to
make you aware exclusively what's going on tomorrow night at Oceans, why we here. I'm going to let Dolly explain. I'm gonna have Josh send some shout outs and we're gonna get up out of here. Dottie, what we got cracking tomorrow night?
So tomorrow night, September 18th, at Ocean Gentlemen's Club, thanks to Debbie. She hooked us up with the Stripper Olympics MMG style.
Love you, Debbie.
By Host Lab of MMG, the greatest motherfucking.
You're supposed to be here today. But we'll get you some. You know, flight delay to have.
So we got
I forgot we supposed to. Yeah, okay, we're going to do this now. Slab, you didn't make that plane. What happened, baby?
What happened, baby? You know what it is.
Hey, look, everybody come out tomorrow night.
To Ocean.
Get ready for tomorrow. What happened, Shotown?
Now, we love you, bro. Man, everybody make some noise. Slab's flight was delayed, so everybody. Hey, look, Slab, this was going down. We finna take this motherfucker up out of here real quick. You were supposed to be in the building, but tomorrow night, everybody fuck with my man, Slab. Fuck with Dolly. It's the Stripper Olympics. Is it the trials?
Trials at 2 p.m.
Man, I'm calling out the whole city, man. I'm calling out the whole city, man. I know people on all sides, man. This is the Stripper Olympics.
Look, yeah, if you ain't turning up.
We got Athena the Goddess coming out of Alabama. Okay.
I'm smacking some ass tomorrow. Look, I promise you.
So listen, I just want all the ladies to know, if you want to dance tomorrow, can you hear me, bro?
Yes, sir. Well, loud and clear. 10-4 copy.
I don't care if you're an amateur. I don't care what you're doing. If you want to represent the shots, and this Chicago versus everybody.
Awesome. I'm calling out all Chicago strippers. I'm calling out all Indiana strippers, all Wisconsin, every little connecting state, Michigan. Yes, come fuck with Slab and Dolly and Debbie tomorrow at Ocean's Nightclub for the Stripper Olympics, man. Hey, Slab, we're going to get with you tomorrow. I'm going to bring some co-hosts, and we're going to rock that thing tomorrow night.
Hey, man, we gonna rock it, man. You know I've been rocking with you for a minute. I just meet you in the city, man. You be everywhere, man.
Man, I promise. I promise I'm there tomorrow, bro. I'm there tonight. I'm there tomorrow, man. Make some noise. John, send some shout-outs out this bitch real quick. It's a movie, baby. It's a movie. Hey, Slab, I'm going to do my shout-outs right now real quick. We got you. It's going to be a movie. We love you. Thank you for calling us, bro.
Man, I love y'all boys, man. Y'all keep watching, man. Shout-out to everybody, man.
Motherfucking Slab in this motherfucker. You
hear me? Ocean, man.
Okay. I'm not done. Josh,
what
take us about this bitch, man. I'm going to find a song, send some shout-outs. Hold on, let me do my shout-outs.
You think?
Mommy, I love you. Red for picking me up on the boat today. And the whole Chicago. I ain't going to lie, I love everybody else. But I'm a competitive Michael Jordan type of motherfucker. It's Chicago versus everybody.
Yeah.
I'm fucking with y'all, though. You know I love y'all. Don't get mad at me. You know,
I got the Atlanta girls coming in, so Chicago, I need y'all to show the fuck out for Chicago, because I've been talking about Chicago.
Send some shout-outs, Dolly, and then Josh.
Shout-out to Pop, shout-out to Deb, shout-out to Josh. You always holding it down. Meeks flew in to come fuck with your girl on this event, because Slack
you rolling?
Take over. Okay. I really appreciate you for getting us in at this time. And definitely we in Chicago, so shout out to motherfucking Carlito.
Gang in this motherfucker. Okay, Josh.
Man, what's happening, man?
Shout outs in this one. You got home in Chicago, so talk your shit real quick. Let them know you in this bitch. Yeah, and you got a little clout around this motherfucker. And if they want to come to Pop Radio, you can make that happen. Yeah.
Hey, look, I want to give a shout out to my hood. You know what I'm saying? I want to give a shout out to the block, to the people. You know what I mean? At the end of the day, everybody, on this little journey we had today alone, man, everybody, it's my boy Bags, man. We almost made it late. We did this with that at the end of the day.
Hey, look it. Shout out to all you beautiful, thick, even the slender, big, little, you know, bump booty
little
girls. You know what I'm saying? Shout out from Big Act, and we out of here.
Oh man, shout outs to everybody. Shout out to the event tomorrow, Friday, September 18th. You know, day party tryouts, 2 to 7. Day party tryouts, 2 to 7. And then the real Olympics start 9-3. Tomorrow.
Yeah. Shout out to your baby mama. I love y'all. It's your boy. Hito Cornito.
Y'all know that's for my nigga. You gotta. I miss you, nigga. We done been through so
touch
much.
Touch a trim, be wildin' with it.
How the fuck I lose my homie? You love Kobe so much, now you flying with Kobe.